Well, we have made it to the weekend. Happy Friday to you. I'm Lucas McFadden. This is CN2 Now. First up tonight, this is the first weekend of the Come See Me Festival. It is finally here, and there are so many activities for you and your family. Here are your latest Come See Me reports.
Well, the Beach Bash is back on again. This is one of the big iconic events, part of the Come See Me Festival. It gets underway at 5:30. It goes until 10. This is what downtown Rock Hill. Mm-hmm. Allison, I know you're a veteran. Mark, you're new.
I'm new to the Beach Bash.
Okay, so I'm going to let Allison go first, and then right. You can sprinkle in your knowledge.
Sounds great.
All right, Allison, let's walk our listeners and viewers through what they all need to know about Beach Bash.
Okay, so it starts at 5:30 downtown off of East Black Street behind Rock Taco. And we'll have about 15 food vendors there, 2 beer trucks. We'll also have wine this year. So the ones that aren't beer drinkers, we have something for you too. We'll have a band, Gary Lauder and the Smoking Hot will be there playing. We'll also have a DJ for intermittent, so the music doesn't stop, it keeps rolling. And we're just going to hang out and have fun and bring your kids. There'll be giveaways. A lot of our sponsors will be giving away cool, like, light-up stuff and cups. So there's a little bit for everybody.
And this is also an event where people can purchase souvenirs as well.
Yes. So we'll have the souvenirs out. So they'll be rolling out with anything that we have sold before and maybe even some new stuff.
And food trucks as well. Right there in the parking lot that's behind Rock Taco.
We'll have about 15. So it'll be sweet, salty, and dinner. So don't eat before you come. Come on and eat while you're there.
Plenty of food.
All right. Well, I mean, that's pretty much everything with Beach Bash. Mark, what did you do as part of this event?
I've learned a lot and hanging out with the frogs.
No. And when you are a Come See Me team leader, it's all hands on deck for sure. In years past, did I make this up or was this a true thing that there was real sand? Like, did they bring in sand ever? Do you remember that?
That was well before my time.
Okay. Okay.
Long time ago.
I'm definitely glad that they're not doing that now.
Add that to your list for next year.
Yes.
Yeah. We're going to scratch that.
Yeah. Mark, what about parking? I mean, a lot of streets downtown will be blocked off. What's the best advice there?
Yep. So the parking lot where the food vendors are going to be is going to be blocked off, as well as East Black Street from City Hall down to the library. You can park in the parking garage behind the Anderson Apartments on Main Street or the Wells Fargo parking lot. Of course, if you are going to be indulging in adult beverages, go ahead and line your Uber up and get a taxi. It'll make it easier and smoother for you.
With you, Gourmet Gardens will get underway at 11 o'clock in the morning. Take our listeners and viewers from there. What do they need to do at 11 o'clock?
Sure, just show up. when you come in for Gourmet, we're going to have about 12 or 13 food trucks there. A variety of different types of food, just kind of like fair carnival type food. A wine truck is really good, a pizza truck. There will be a number of different sponsors there. I think we have 6 sponsors this year. Our law firm, Wilkerson Jones and Wilkerson, shameless plug, we're going to be one of the sponsors. We'll be doing a raffle. There'll be a TV giveaway with the raffle. A couple Stanley Cups will be given out. There's also like a fun zone for your kids. So while you're eating and hanging out, you can let your kids play. And then Julia will tell you about Hops at the Park, which is kind of right next door to us. And if you want, you can get you a beer while your kids are playing.
Well, let's tell folks where Gourmet Gardens is located.
All right. Winthrop Lake. So if you go to the Coliseum in the lower parking lot, there will be, again, about 12 trucks set up. There will be a sponsor tent area, a play area there by the lake. And then Julia will probably tell you a little bit more about the concert. But there will be some live music down by the lake as well.
So it's right there, right where the finish line is for the road race.
It is.
Okay.
It is.
Perfect. Okay, Julia, now it's your big time in the spotlight.
You're up.
I know you love being interviewed, so we're excited that you're here. Hops at the Park will get underway at what, 1 o'clock?
Technically, we are 1 to 6 p.m. We've got a variety of different options to how you want to do the beers. If you're doing the road race in the morning, there is actually a beer ticket included in your race bib. So we will be open as early as 9 a.m. for those runners. But then the actual event will kick off at 1. And this is something you can just show up, walk up. Obviously, you got to be 21, bring your IDs. We are cash and credit. This will be a $5 beer token. So you can come back as many times as you like. That it's, whatever you'd like to do. Additionally, we have a VIP area. And this is a ticketed event. Only 21 and up are allowed in here. So if you're interested in that, leave your kids at home. That is $40 today if you want to. It's through Eventbrite on the website. And then if you show up tomorrow, it'll be $45 the day of.
Carolina Connection is brought to you by Wild Birds Unlimited. For more information, visit rockhill.wbu.com or indianland.wbu.com. Wild Birds Unlimited. We bring people and nature together.
Okay, still to come here on CN2 Now, it's a big weekend for the York County Choral Society, and also happening this weekend in the city of York. You've got Sliver in the City. We're going to learn more about those Airstreams who are rolling into town straight ahead.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
When it comes to prescription medications and health needs, Rock Hill residents have been turning to Good Pharmacy for over 50 years.
I've been coming to Good Pharmacy since we came to Rock Hill in 1984, and I would not change pharmacists for anything.
With their knowledgeable staff, you can always trust that your prescription will be filled with complete confidence and care for your health. Good Pharmacy, conveniently located at the corner of Ebenezer Road and Camden Avenue.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
We know the type. You like to start early, finish late, make lemon squares, and make payments to the college fund from anywhere in the house. We know you rely on Comporium for the things you rely on most, like a view of the backyard. That's just a bunny, and hundreds of channels to watch whenever you want. So you may think of us as just your internet company, but we're more like the I didn't know they could do all that company. Comporium, always ready.
You're watching CN2 Now. The 7th annual Sliver in the City event is taking place this weekend in York with those Airstreams rolling into town. This is your chance to see this one-of-a-kind event. Learn how special these Airstreams are from the Palmetto State Airstreamers Club.
What I really love is that not only is this happening in our downtown, a lot of our downtown restaurants, businesses, churches, organizations are having collaborative events going on, like Yorkville Marketplace. They're having some live entertainment. A lot of the churches are having bake sales and yard sales. Garden Cafe down the street's having a spring market. There's so much going on. If you're bored, you're not looking in the right place.
Well, I see Terry and John over there shaking their heads. Yep, yep. So Terry and John, you both are with the Palmetto State Airstream Club. Why, what in the world is with the Airstreams, and why the city of York, of all places?
Well, first of all, it's our hometown, and we love our hometown. And we're just using the Airstream as hopefully as a medium to attract people to come to York as a draw. And we want them specifically to come to York and patronize Main Street, the small business owners. The small business owners are a dying breed if you look around. That's tough. It's tough on them.
It sure is.
And we want to help them any way we can. Now, you know, we know one weekend don't win the championship, but you got to start somewhere.
It's true. And yeah, it brings in hundreds of thousands. What is, you know, John, what do you think, how many people are expected to turn out this weekend?
Well, we never know, but I would say the last few years on Main Street, Saturday afternoon, between 3,000 and 5,000 people.
Wow.
Yeah.
So just think about that.
So you got to remember this. Congress Street, which is our main street, mm-hmm, will be closed to vehicle traffic. So it makes it very family friendly, user friendly. You don't have to worry about getting run over. The airstreams will be open. And so it's a very festive event, as well as have all these iconic silver trailers down there.
And guys, what is it about the Airstream that makes it unique? This is for specifically Airstreams. I know some other people may have motor vehicles and that type of stuff. This is specific for Airstreams. So why Airstreams?
Go, John.
Well, we get asked that question a lot. Yeah. What makes an Airstream so special? Well, I'll tell you what. It's the short version of that is they've remained essentially unchanged since 1931, since the very first one was ever produced. They've had very little structural or visual changes. So they got they're all silver. They're all aluminum. And people, most everybody on the planet has seen one somewhere along the line going down the road, and they're hard to miss. And so it's an iconic thing.
Well, and I think it's a lot of people's dream to own an Airstream. I mean, I don't want anybody to take this the wrong way, but getting an Airstream is not a cheap proposition by any stretch of the imagination. So you got to think about that thing and look at it. Basically, it's an investment and something you're going to hold on to and possibly pass down to your family members, because they'll last a long time if you take care of them.
Yeah. Was the purpose of these Airstreams to be a accessory to help with traveling on the road to live in? Like, what was the original purpose back in the day? Was it a home or more of an accessory?
Oh, it's about traveling.
Travel.
Okay.
They were built to travel. That's why they're aerodynamic. That's why they're built the way they're built, to be pulled like a stream of air.
Yeah.
It's what in the Wally Baum, who I guess you'd say invented the very first one, started this whole Airstream thing. That was his saying. They pull like a stream of air, and then he figured out that didn't sound good, and he called them Airstream. But they're meant for traveling.
And yeah, I mean, you guys can correct me if I'm wrong here, but the explosion of Airstreams really happened during the 50s with the interstates when they opened up. That was where everybody, to your point, that was kind of you've succeeded. Like, you've hit the big time when you can have that Airstream parked in your driveway and can haul it as a family across the country and go to the national parks and that type of stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Well, so Chloe, I'm going to pass it back to you. When you say that there's going to be the open house, you can go in and tour some of these Airstreams. What is the most extravagant ones that you all have seen?
Oh, gosh. The most extravagant?
And anyone can chime in.
Well, what do you think, Terry? What's the most extravagant one you've seen?
And it can't be yours.
Mine's pretty simple. The vintage rigs are pretty darn nice, and people take a lot of pride in those, especially the folks that have the vintage rigs and they keep them original.
And what would you define as vintage? How far back is that?
That 25 years, John? 25 years or older?
My trailer is 31 years old, and it's considered vintage.
Okay.
But we got one that we know of. It's in my yard right now. It's a 1960 model.
Holy smokes.
The vintage trailers always attract the most attention because it has got a different look. They still have that silver bullet shape, but they are very distinctive.
Does it not stress you out with the aluminum on the road and getting the nicks and dings from rocks? Isn't that a hard thing to want to take your fancy trailer out?
All of us is nightmares, a hailstorm.
I bet.
Hey, if you use it, only way you can keep that thing pristine is take it home, put it in the garage, and don't ever do anything with it.
Which I bet some people do. They don't take advantage of the whole Airstream purpose to travel. So do you guys go out often and travel across the country with yours?
We've crisscrossed the country numerous times.
He's done that.
They're made to travel.
Yeah.
Wow.
They don't do well sitting still.
No.
They don't do well. So they're made to travel. The very first one, when Wally Baum came up with the concept, Wally Baum, the founder, came out of the aircraft industry. So he's already familiar with that aerodynamical aluminum semi-monocoque construction, but he had every intention to use them to travel. He was a forward-thinking man and died in 1955, but anyway.
Speaking of travel, where's the furthest one that you guys know of that'll be coming this weekend to Silver in the City?
The furthest away.
I know there's at least one coming from Canada, but I don't know which part of Canada, but they've been here before.
Still pretty far.
Yeah.
Our fire chief said they saw that one from Canada coming into town the other day.
I'll be darned.
I know.
As you heard, there are many events taking place in the city of York in the downtown area for Silver in the City, so simply head there and have some fun.
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? Yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
From my first watch I purchased as a teenager, which still runs today, to the diamond ring I surprised my wife with, which she still talks about today, a gift from Norman Hagee is as good as it gets. Whether it's elegant timepieces by Bulova, Caravelle, and Bel Air, or ornamental ironwork-inspired Southern Gates collection, or dazzling fine jewelry, a gift from Hagee is backed by over 60 years of family-owned and operated experience. Norman Hagee Jewelers, for gifts as good as it gets.
For over 60 years, Gill Insurance has been lucky enough to serve the wonderful people of York County. Everything we do is done with the best interest of our customers and our community in mind. We want to thank each and every one of you who've trusted us to insure their most important assets.
Call on the Gill agencies in Rock Hill, Fort Mill, and now in Mount Pleasant. Independent agents proudly representing Auto Owners Insurance Company.
Welcome back to CN2 Now. The York County Choral Society is now in its 42nd season, and it's got a big concert happening this Sunday. Here are some of the performers.
What do you want our community to know about the Choral Society? How long you've been around? What do you typically do? What do your concerts look like? And then we'll go from there.
Well, we are in our 42nd consecutive year of performing, so that's longer than most any group in the art world in our region, so we are excited to continue that tradition. We currently have 66 singers who will be performing on that Sunday, April 14th at Unity Presbyterian Church in Fort Mill, South Carolina, and we are also excited to once again introduce fairly new artistic directors. This will be their second concert. Elizabeth Mixon and Randy Emler are our co-artistic directors. And this program is absolutely fascinating. And our tickets are available on our website. And we have a really important announcement for our listeners. We had an incredible sellout in December. So we have decided no tickets at the door. All tickets are in advance online. So buy your tickets now. The concert's great.
Well, I mean, that's a kudos to you all for selling out. Yes. Pretty much. That's fantastic. Yes. So it sounds like you do two concerts a year.
Yes.
Typically in the fall and one in the spring.
Correct.
This one in the spring, it's titled Music, the Heart of America. Excuse me. I was going to call it Music from the Heartland, but the Heart of America. So what can we expect?
Well, Tyler is an expert in music, and this concert is incredible.
Okay, Tyler.
Expert is a strong word.
Yes.
No, Kim, that's a great overview of the society. And just to give you a little bit more background on that, as far as who is participating in this concert, we've got folks from three different counties that sing with us. It's not just York County in itself. It's Chester County, Lancaster County as well. We're growing there. We're growing our business sponsorships. 18 businesses to date or local folks who buy ads, purchase ads, support these performances, and over 100 patrons right now. So we're 100% donor-funded, relationship-funded, community-funded from the folks that you live around and that sing.
And so we're an organization that the community gives to. We're an organization that gives to the community, and it's an organization that's a community in itself. And so when looking at the literature for this semester, our co-artistic director's pitch to us, we want to do something from the heart of America. Mm-hmm. And I want to read kind of their background. You get a program when you come to our concert, and it will have a welcome in it. And it'll say, this is what the program is, this is how we arrived here. And so I just want to read two short snippets from this. The first is, in the great melting pot of the United States, music from the heart of America is both unique to our land and an amalgamation of styles and genres of music from across the globe. The composers and arrangers featured in today's concert are Americans, and the harmonies, textures, and rhythms you will hear in their music are easily identifiable as possessing a uniquely American sound. So these are our folks, these are our people, and there's three main areas that this concert focuses on. It's American art music that you think of as individual. If somebody's going into a voice lesson or somebody is singing an individual song at church, that would be considered sacred to American art music. The second is shape note tunes. Those are your hymn tunes that you think of. Amazing Grace is a shape note tune, and it has origins there. And the last is the African American spiritual. The composers in this span over the past 22 centuries of the U.S., so we've got a little bit that harkens way back, and the most recent is that African American spiritual or quasi-gospel type sound that we end with in there. And it's great choral literature. Mm. And I will say this is in their conclusion paragraph of the welcome. The program offers a homegrown musical perspective which spans the previous two centuries, and that's where we are. We're here to educate, we're here to perform as well, and we're here for people to have a good time.
The York County Choral Society will present The Heart of America, as Tyler just described right there, on Sunday, April the 14th, 4 o'clock at Unity Presbyterian Church there in Fort Mill, up on the hill, gorgeous venue. So that's a check in the win column. Go ahead and get your tickets now, as Kim explained to us, that they sold out of the last one. They're not going to sell tickets at the door, so you need to act fast and act today. Harriet, you're going to be the incoming president for the York County Choral Society. I know you're celebrating your 42nd season. What does the 43rd season look like? And is this a society where if people are listening right now and they like to sing, but they don't maybe have an outlet to sing, that they can audition throughout the year to be part of these concerts?
Absolutely. We do auditions really any time during the season, but primarily at the beginning of each semester. Well, we're always welcoming new voices, talented people who just want the experience of singing and singing with joy. You know, we are very fortunate. We still have the deep roots of some charter members singing with us, as well as the new growth of new voices coming in. We have the wonderful qualifications of these artistic directors, Elizabeth Mixon, Randy Immler. We have support of our community. We have a board that is dedicated to keeping this organization going and thriving. So we have a true opportunity to enhance and to preserve. We want to preserve everything that this organization has stood for 42 years, but we want to enhance it further so that it will last another 42 years.
I have to say, of all the organizations that we get to interview on this show, having some of them be 10, 20 years is impressive, but 42 years, that's a long time.
Is a long time. David Lowry and Shirley Fishburn are the originators, the organizers of this group. And so we continue on.
Tyler, how important is it for communities to have a choral society like this? Is it rare to have a choral society? Are there others in the state of South Carolina?
There are others. Our closest ones to us in the state are in Greenville, as well as in the Columbia area. But I'll say that the importance of this element of music grew during COVID, because the one thing that you couldn't do was sing in a community setting during COVID. Everybody who went to church, they saw their church choir stop. You went to virtual worship. Schools were out. You couldn't do school chorus, high school chorus. and as well as the Choral Society. They made it through there, but they did have to skip a concert in that. And so what this does is it fills that gap as things start to get back to normal and things start to are still in that world or are figuring out how do we do this safely, how do we do this productively. But a lot of those programs didn't come back that were smaller. And so we serve that need as well in this community for those folks to have an outlet.
And see, with us straight ahead here on CN2 Now, a big honor given out by the Boy Scouts to a Tri-County educator.
We know the type. You like to start early, finish late, make lemon squares, and make payments to the college fund from anywhere in the house. We know you rely on Comporium for the things you rely on most, like a view of the backyard. That's just a bunny, and hundreds of channels to watch whenever you want. So you may think of us as just your internet company, but we're more like the I didn't know they could do all that company. Comporium, always ready.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
My dad is my hero. He taught me how to fish and play baseball. He never stopped looking out for me. I guess he never stopped thinking of me as his little boy, but I don't mind, because I am. What I admired about him most was that he always thought of everything. He even pre-planned his funeral. He planned the perfect celebration of his life. He'll always be my hero.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
Welcome back to CN2 Now. Let's get a check of your CN2 Now picture of the day. During the Rock Hill School District Board meeting, the Palmetto Council of the Boy Scouts of America presented the Albert K. Fretwell Outstanding Educator Award to John Price, a teacher at Castle Heights Middle School. So way to go, Mr. Price. Congratulations. Well, that will do it for us for now here on CN2 Now, but you can catch us bright and early at 6 a.m. on Palmetto Mornings right here on CN2, as well as on the radio, FM 100.1, and many of our social media platforms on the WRHI and CN2 channels.
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? Yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
When your gutters need repair, call the company that's been providing roofing and gutter services since 1939, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company. We offer full gutter service, from simple repairs to complete replacement, gutter guards, and even gutter cleanings. In fact, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company was voted Charlotte's best gutter service company by the readers of The Observer. When it comes to your gutter needs, call the best. H&S Roofing and Gutter Company, serving the Carolinas since 1939.
My dad is my hero. He taught me how to fish and play baseball. He never stopped looking out for me. I guess he never stopped thinking of me as his little boy, but I don't mind, because I am. What I admired about him most was that he always thought of everything. He even pre-planned his funeral. He planned the perfect celebration of his life. He'll always be my hero.